It is Monday. It's Tuesday. No, it's Wednesday, my dudes. Gonna go for a run. Gonna go to the gym and hit back. And then I'm gonna show you guys my secret protein shake recipe. Don't tell anybody. Guys, here it is, the secret protein shake recipe. You're gonna take some whey protein, some tuna, Johnny seasoning salt, bananas, a little bit of mustard, a little bit of salsa, some cayenne pepper, and some strawberry jam. It doesn't really matter the macros on these, because you're gonna take all these and put them right back in the fucking fridge, because that's disgusting. All you really need is this right here. Little bit of whey, a little bit of water. Keep it simple. Get it right, get it tight. It is Wednesday, my dudes. So I didn't actually make a protein shake. I'm gonna be making a video on how to make the best protein shake you've ever tasted in your life. So that's gonna be coming up. But in light of my other video, it seemed like people were kind of digging the motivational part at the end. So I thought I'd throw another one in here. And usually I just like to talk about, you know, what's currently going on in my life and what I'm learning and reading and what's kind of the theme for the week. So for me, something that I've been doing lately that's just really been helping me a lot and making me feel very fulfilled and happy is, instead of designing the perfect life and trying to, you know, imagine yourself living
this perfect life that you want, which is great. You should have that. You should have that in your goals and in your vision. But for me, something I learned from Frank Kern is try designing the perfect day. So a perfect day, like, what does that look like? Because looking at a perfect life, it's too broad. It's too general. The perfect day, you can really narrow it down to where you can wake up and you can focus on that day. You know, in recovery, it's one day at a time. So focusing on that one day, like, where are you waking up at? What city are you waking up at? What state? Maybe a different country. Who are you waking up next to? You know, who's your ideal partner? What does it look like when you wake up? What do you do? Your morning routine. Like, I like to meditate. I like to write down my goals. And I like to pray. Something that I also like to do is go to the gym. You know, maybe that's not it for you, but maybe it's go out to brunch with your friends, you know, or go and go straight to work on your business that you started. Designing the perfect day is empowering. It's awesome, and it makes it tangible because it's something that you can do every day and work towards. What kind of house or room or bed are you living in? Are you sleeping in a bunk bed, or are you sleeping in like a California king, you know, a bed made for a king? The thing about your mind is that it really is like a garden. Like Joe Dirt says, life's a garden, man, dig it. You need to consciously, proactively be planting seeds of positivity, determination, motivation, and thoughts and feelings and emotions that empower you. It's really like a funnel. Whatever you're putting in your head day by day, whether it's books, movies, motivational videos, listening to speakers, hanging out with good, positive friends, whatever you're putting in is what's gonna come out. And instead of being at the effect of life to where you're just kind of a zombie, you're going through life, you're distracted. I mean, there's so much marketing, there's so much commercials and stuff that wants to grab your attention and distract you. But really, Jim Rohn says, stand guard at the door to your mind. There's all this stuff that if you just let it in, it will take root in there after a while. And that's what's going to be coming out. So one thing I like to do is read and watch motivational videos and listen to music that makes me feel good and have positive conversations with people. And over time, it's been rewiring my brain to only look at the positive, to only be optimistic. And when I hear something negative, or I'm around somebody that's kind of negative, we're like two opposite magnets. It's like we don't really vibe, we don't really gel, and we separate. And that's good, because people that are in a different state of mind, a different place in life, that's cool. Love them for where they are. Don't try to change them. The only thing you can do is really just shine, man. Like, you just gotta shine your light on the world and let people that are on your wavelength come to you. But back to the perfect day. That's why I started the Wednesday, my dudes, last week. And I didn't come up with that saying, by the way. I found it from a Vine that's super funny. You should check it out. But I just adopted it because it made me feel good. It is Wednesday, my dude. Wake up every day. Have a theme for the day. Like me, I have like Motivation Monday, Terminator Tuesday. It's Wednesday, my dude. Workout Wednesday. And wake up and just focus on having just the best one day of your life. Like today I woke up, I said, I'm going to make this the best freaking Wednesday of my life. I'm going to be happy. I'm going to move forward. And I'm going to make progress today. If you really want to know the secret to feeling happy, progress. It's progress. Whether it's one step forward in fitness, in business, in your finances, your relationships, whatever it is, progress, not perfection. Progress equals happiness. Just remember that, my friends. But anyways, almost to work. Hope you liked it. The video, it was okay because I didn't really have a lot of time to film all the exercises I was doing in the gym, but I did my best. Progress, not perfection. I love you guys. I'll see you guys in a couple days. Gonna be putting up that protein shake video, so check it out. Leave a comment, subscribe. Love you guys. Peace.